day, found myself in the city near Piccadilly. Don't really know how I got here. I got some bitches on my phone, new names and numbers that I don't know. Address to places like Abbey Road. Day turns to night, night turns to whatever we want. We're young enough to say, oh, this is gotta be Colorado. Sometimes there's airplanes I can't jump out. Sometimes there's bullshit that don't work. Now we have got our stories, but please tell me what there's to complain about. When you're happy like a fool, you let it take you over. When everything is out, you gotta take it in.
It's Bill Smith getting on the big green sign. He approaches the quarter mark of the strip, going wild up to halfway. He's on it and into the three-quarter. He's really coming on and into the traps with a top time, a top conduct time of 170.45 miles per hour. 170.45 miles per hour with the top time of the meet.
And then the awards. The trophy for traveling the greatest distance to the Nationals, accepted by Mike Bamber. The
There's at least one chow hound in every group. Nick was ours. Nick and Mike had farther to come than we did, so we set up a rendezvous. Safer to travel by caravan, it's more fun too. We hadn't been able to get together because of the hectic weeks of work that always precede a big meet. So there was lots to talk about. New ideas, things that worked and things that didn't work. A dragliner was our last year's winner. Nick purchased it when we built the Dragmaster. Mike and Nick were running it this year. It's a long haul from California to Detroit, so Lefty broke up to powwow and we got underway.
Now me and my wife and my brother Joe took off my Ford from San Pedro. We hadn't much gas, the tires were low, but the dad blamed Ford, didn't barely go. Now along about the middle of the night, we were ripping along like nice folks might. And the Mercury behind, he blinked his lights, he honked his horn, and he flew out of sight. We had twin pipes and Columbia butts, your people may think that I'm in a rut. But to you folks who don't take a jive, that's two carburetors and an overdrive. We made three spots out of many good towns and left the cops' heads spinning round and round. They wouldn't chase, they'd run and hide, but me and that Mercury stayed side to side. Now we were Ford men and we likely knew that we would race until something blew. My foot feeders down like we're stuck with glue through many of the towns we flew and flew. I looked down at my lovely bride, her face was blue, I thought she'd died. Left streaks through town about 40 feet wide, me and that Mercury stayed side by side. My brother was pale, he said he was sick, he said he was just a nervous wreck, but why should I worry for what the heck? Me and that Mercury was still.
Up at Westworld in Scottsdale, Arizona, and our speed continuing live coverage of the 40th annual Barrett Jackson Collector Car Auction presented by Ford. There's our number four Hagerty Fantasy Bid vehicle. It is now on the auction block and the bidding is closed. We'll have the numbers for you shortly. Thank you very much. I'll leave it up to you, Steve Bagnate. Is this like finding a dinosaur bone out there in the desert?
Well, yeah, it really is. I mean, you know, historians and enthusiasts of drag racing will understand what this car is. It's basically a blown gasser, and it's one of the very few Chevrolet-powered supercharged gassers that were running, one of the very last. And of course, we have the 671 blower, Hillborn mechanical injection, a hand-formed aluminum scoop, and all of this is sitting on top of an iron-headed Corvette motor. Now, this engine here probably makes around 670 horsepower, but it's based on a Willys pickup truck with the top chopped down a few inches. But this is the real thing. Hot Rod Deluxe magazine did a wonderful feature on this car a couple of issues back. And again, it's a time capsule found as it was put away. On the rear, we see some vintage M&H Racemaster drag slicks and those beautiful magnesium torque thrust rims. Boy, oh boy, it's a snapshot, a time capsule of one of the most popular classes in drag racing in the early 1960s. And it's not seen the light of day in a very long time, and what a neat vehicle.
Be a great addition to a drag racing museum anywhere. I know Big Daddy Don Garlitz has a great one down in Ocala, Florida. I know the NHRA has one up in California. What a piece. Steve Bagnate, we've gotten some emails asking why we're pronouncing it Willys and not Willys. Care to go over the explanation again?
Well, sure. I mean, just to be perfectly technically correct, Willys is how the company referred to itself, although so many people call it Willys, myself included, really. Willys, Willys, you know, as you say, potato, potato. But inside this car, we can see there's a hump behind a handmade aluminum firewall. The motor is set back quite a bit. That's why there's a little bump there. The distributor lives right back there. And, you know, the roll bar is, well, it's for token use, I suppose. Obviously, it hasn't, $42,000. Nice.
$42,000. Well done. We've got another break coming up, but lots more coming your way halfway through our fourth hour of 11. Here at the 40th annual Barrett Jackson Collector Car Auction, presented by Ford.
Chances are when said and done. Get up. chances are the fascination.
Chances won't escape from me. Chances are only what we make them. And all I need.
Thank you. you'll find a pot of gold at the end of a story. You'll find it's all been told, but our love has a treasure our hearts can always spend, and it has a story without any end. At the end of a river, the water stops its flow. At the end of a highway, there's no place you can go. But just tell me you love me, and you are only mine, and our love will go on till the end of time. At the end of a river, the water stops its flow. At the end of a highway, there's no place you can go. But just tell me you love me, and you are only mine, and our love will go on till the end of time.
Every tree. One pair of hands formed the valleys, the ocean, the rivers, and the sand. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong, put your faith into one pair of hands. One pair of hands heal the sick. One pair of hands raise the dead. One pair of hands calm the raging storm, and thousands of people were fed. One pair of hands said, "I love you." And those hands were nailed to a tree. Those hands are so strong, so when life goes wrong, put your faith into one pair of hands.
The better part of me, I'm more than a bird. some pretty face beside a train, and it's not easy to be me. I wish that I could cry, fall upon my knees, find a way to lie about a home I'll never see. It may sound absurd,
thousands of miles I fly,
with you, I'll be there. Don't be afraid, oh my love, I'll be watching. Just think of
Thank you.